signify by saying amen.
Amen.
I wait for you. Hallelujah. God is good. God is good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
First Kings 18 and 21.
Hallelujah.
And I'm just going to read one verse.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody got it?
Amen.
Okay, it reads as follows. And Elijah came unto all the people. And he said, how long halt ye between two opinions? If the Lord be God, follow him. But if Baal, then follow him. And the people answered him not a word.
Not a word.
Look at the person that's standing next to you. Eyeball to eyeball contact. And tell them you are standing at the crossroads.
Yeah.
Standing at the crossroads.
Yeah.
Of your enemy.
Of your enemy.
Again, you're standing at the crossroads.
You're standing at the crossroads.
Of your enemy.
Of your enemy.
Now, first of all, I want to define the word crossroads.
All right.
Let me define the word. Showdown.
Yes. Well, yes. Yes.
Now a showdown is basically means to the front.
Dylan.
It means
Dylan.
Confrontation. Mm-hmm. It means that you're facing something that you've been preparing for.
Mm-hmm.
You're facing something that you haven't been preparing for. Somebody say crossroads.
Crossroads.
And to explain the word crossroads and give an example, it's like. In your life, we're in a season and a time where everything in our life that's been going on in our life is coming up against us at the same time. And it's fighting us tooth and nail. Somebody say crossroads.
Crossroads.
And it's just like, if I could give an example, it's just like a boxer, two boxers who are preparing for a fight. And they're preparing for three, four, 5 months in this particular fight. And they've been doing a lot of talking. They've been doing a lot of training. And then it comes to the press conference. They do some more talking. And then the moment of truth gets here where both are in the ring.
Yes, yes.
And get ready to get it on. Somebody say get it on.
Get it on.
And see, that's where we're at. We're at the crossroads of our destiny. We're at the crossroads of our fear. We're at the crossroads of things that have been fighting us with bills and the troubles in our life. We're at the crossroads. And at this place, let me explain something. At this particular place, and the only way that you will be able to defeat your enemy, there are two points that I want to talk about that's going to come from your eyes and your mouth. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Now your eyes come from the book of Hebrews, the 11th chapter, the first verse where it says, the Bible says that now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And now we're going to talk about the mouth. Now the Bible says in the book of Matthew, the 15th chapter, and the 11th verse, where Jesus was talking to disciples, and he said that it's not what goes into the mouth, but what comes out the mouth that defiles a man.
Yeah.
Somebody say mouth.
Mouth.
Now see, you must be careful with your mouth, because even Jesus had even talked to the disciples, and he told his disciples to be careful how you hear. Because it's in how you hear that will determine how you respond.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And now at this place of confrontation, at this place of meeting your enemy, now somebody say pressure. Now people can talk about how strong they are, and people can talk about how bad they are. But let me explain something to you. Based on what's inside of you, will determine how you're going to respond. Because if you have doubt in you, if you have fear in you, when you meet your giant, when you meet your enemy, you're going to become fearful and you're going to feel defeated. But if you have the faith of God in you, and see, the faith of God is the lens of God, it's going to reflect, and what's going to come out your mouth is faith. What's going to come out your mouth is victory. Moses. And,
yes,
when it was time for the children of Israel to go over into the land of Canaan, and they was at the brink. They was at the brink of their destiny, where it was time to go over. It was time to move forward. It was time to do what God had promised them many years ago. And they got to a place where Moses sent out 12 spies. Somebody say spies.
Spies.
Now there was 10. There was 10 spies who went out.
Well.
And they saw the land.
Yeah.
They saw what was going on.
Yeah.
And they brought back a report of fear.
Well.
And the lens of their eyes. See, the thing about your eyes. So your eyes, based on what's in you, you will see when you see your enemy. If you walk by faith, if you walk by faith, your eyes are going to see victory.
Come on,
because if you think about the eyes, if you look at the, that was a time where one night when I was when I went to sleep, and then when I went to sleep, I woke up. And see, when you have the faith of God, you have the eyes of God. Even like the prophets of old. And see, there's another eye. There's a new dimension, another dimension. And that dimension is God. And see, the prophets of old saw that. And see, the prophets of old, when they spoke from what they saw. They spoke about God. They spoke about joy. They spoke about victory. And see, what faith is, when God is in you, when you see your enemy, your enemy is going to be as a grasshopper. See, because God, the God in you is big. Which means everything around you is going to be small. Somebody say amen. But then you look at the 10 who came back with the report of fear. And see, the still, the